Hey, hello, welcome or welcome back to my channel, and welcome to a very overdue video about Good Omens. So, way back in June, way back in June, myself, Chattie from The Mad Chatterer, and Matt from Baskin Story, we buddy read Good Omens. Now, this was a reread for myself, and because I read it last year. I want to say it was last year. Time moves very weirdly for me sometimes, but yeah. So this was a reread for me, and I loved it as much as I did the first time around. Shall I be holding the book up? Should I? Maybe. It can distract from my face. Alright, so. According to the nice and accurate prophecies of Agnes and Notter, that's one way to pronounce it, the world's only totally reliable guide to the future, the world would end on a Saturday. Next Saturday, in fact, just after tea. And someone seems to have misplaced the Antichrist. Good Omens is one of those books that it either works for you or it doesn't. I feel like there's a very clear divide of which side you end up on. So it's chock full of humor that may not translate to everyone. For one, it is a very British, and two, this book was written in the late 80s, so some of the jokes may be a bit dated. So if you were born like from 2000 and onwards, you might miss a thing or two. Honestly, it all just depends on how and what you were raised on. So the basic plot is that the angel Aziraphale and the demon Crowley have found themselves liking Earth a bit, maybe too much for what a demon and an angel should. They are living on it, the Earth, and enjoying all its pleasures, you know, maybe a bit too much in some cases. So when they find out the end date of the end of the world, they try to stop it. Moving on to the TV series, or the, I guess, Amazon Prime. What does it say on it? It says, now a Prime original and BBC series, so it's a Prime BBC combination of sorts. I watched it on Prime. You watch it wherever you can. I don't know. Anyway, so the first series of Good Omens, it follows the book pretty accurately, I want to say. Some of the like jokes and plotline of it all has been updated, like they have cell phones in it and mobile phones, whichever kind of pronunciation, that's that whichever word you want to use for an iPhone, basically. They have that, but the basic gist of the book is in the series. So yes, it's basically just updated to fit the times, but it holds true, it holds very much true to the original book. And then we have season 2, or series 2, whichever way you want to say it, it's basically the same thing, and this just came out, and this is kind of the reason why this video is so delayed in my YouTube progress here. But yeah, I basically waited for season 2 to come out so I could watch that as well to chat about in this video, which you are now watching. Hey! So, season 2. It doesn't have a book to be based on because there's only one book in the Good Omens world, as it were. So we have a new plot. We have some new characters, we have some old characters coming back, and we have some new characters. And in the series, we have some of the characters have new faces, and some of the like actors from series one have come back to series two as new characters. So it's kind of a spot the thingy. I don't know. Where's Wally? I don't know. So whereas series one was very much about preserving life, series two is very much about love and all the way shapes and forms it comes in. Honestly, the casting is phenomenal. Michael Sheen and David Tennant's partnering is just chef's kiss, and it's like the book were written for them specifically. And I mean, it wasn't. It wasn't, but it's like, it's there. It's just perfect. Honestly, I think that even if you don't like the book, you will like the show. Because it's different, it's the same, but it's different in a way that maybe the visual aspect will translate to more people than the book can. The aim of this video is basically read Good Omens and watch the series, because phenomenal. yes. Also, while we're here, can we talk about the cliffhanger in series two? Because, what? Excuse me? Series three better be, like, in the works right now, because I want it tomorrow. Hello? I'm phoning you up right now. Where is season three? I need it. I need it, like, yesterday. So, thank you so much for watching this video. Please do comment down below. Have you read the book? Have you watched the series? What are your thoughts? Let's have a little chat about it, shall we? And yeah, thank you for being here. Thank you for watching my strange videos. And yeah, I'll see you next time. Take care. Bye-bye.